Summertime means fresh tomatoes, so I'm going to show you how to make one of my all-time favorite recipes, the caprese salad. So delicious, loaded with fresh tomatoes, so easy to make, I know you will love this recipe. If you search for caprese salad online, you're going to see a ton of different variations. I've seen onions in there, avocado, kale even. It is so much simpler than that. The one that you're looking for is the ensalada di caprese. Now, with that being said, there is one ingredient I do see a lot of folks put in there, and that's reduced balsamic. I'm not a huge fan of it, but I do want to show you how to make it just so you can get it right. Sound good? Let's cook. We are going to start by slicing up a lemon in half. I was always told to cut reduced balsamic with a little bit of clean acid like lime or lemon. So I'm squeezing it right into a medium-sized sauce pot. I always keep my other hand there to catch any of the seeds and let the liquid run through, like you see here. Perfect. Now I'm going to add in a bit of balsamic vinegar. Normally, I would say always use a high-quality balsamic, but when you're reducing it, you're concentrating the flavor, and you're not going to know if it's an expensive bottle or a cheaper bottle. So my recommendation is use a cheaper bottle. Crank the heat onto high. We're going to reduce it by about 2/3, but this is sometimes hard to figure out. So the best way that I know how is to take it to 226 degrees. And as soon as it gets there, we're going to take it off the heat. Like I said earlier, reduced balsamic is classically not used in a caprese salad, but I wanted to show you how to do it just in case you do want it. But I promise you again, you don't need it. Now, what we need to do is transfer the hot balsamic vinegar into a different dish. I have a shatterproof glass that can take high heat things. So I'm just going to scrape all that goodness in there. And what I want to do is put it in the refrigerator. It takes about 20 to 25 minutes for it to completely cool. And you will immediately notice just how thick it is, making it perfect if you want to use it on this caprese salad. The very reason this is a summer recipe is because all of the fresh tomatoes. Now, I love an assortment. Heirlooms, vine ripes, cherries, different colors. It will bring about so much more flavor. However, you can absolutely just use one breed of tomato. This part is completely up to you. You'll obviously save a lot more money if you just buy Romas or vine ripes. But for me, I like all these different things in here. So now let's slice them up. I'm gonna start with some vine ripe tomatoes, simply remove them off the vine. Then I'm gonna cut out the stem. When it comes to these bigger tomatoes, just a good idea. It's bitter, it's kind of hard to chew, it's a little bit nasty. So I also insist on slicing these into little wedges. They should be bite-sized pieces. There's nothing worse than getting a huge chunk of tomato that you can barely fit in your mouth. And the same thing goes with these little cherry tomatoes. These are super sweet, but I'm just gonna cut them and keep them in uniform shape with the other wedge style cuts that I'm doing. I also have some yellow teardrops. When it comes to tomatoes, it's much like bell peppers. Green are okay, red are sweet, yellows are even sweeter, and orange are super sweet. The same thing with tomatoes. When you get to those different colors, they can be incredibly sweet. I also have some heirloom tomatoes. They are in season. They are absolutely delicious. I'm going to remove that stem and I'm going to slice them up. And if I am ever using a larger heirloom tomato that I slice into wedge, I cut that in half as well, just like you see here. Cut as many tomatoes up as you would like, and I'm just going to set them to the side on a plate or a sheet tray lined with parchment paper. Now, you want to take this thing to the next level? You absolutely have to use buffalo mozzarella. It's real mozzarella that comes from buffalo's milk. Now, the stuff we get here in the United States is more like hardened milk, not a lot of flavor. Now, you can find buffalo mozzarella. It may be a little tough to do, but I promise you it will be worth it. If you can't get it and you just have to buy the ball of mozzarella, so be it. We'll make it work. Now, let's slice it up. Go ahead and remove it from the liquid package that it's sitting in. I'm going to simply put it right down on my cutting board, and then I want to slice it up. And again, it's all about keeping that uniform shape. So the same thing with the buffalo mozzarella as I did with tomatoes. I'm going to slice it in half, and then I'm going to cut it into little bite-sized wedges. Again, you want to be able to fit a piece of mozzarella in your mouth. You don't want to have this gigantic thing that you're chomping on. So slice them into small wedges, and just like the tomatoes, we're going to set them to the side on a plate or a sheet tray lined with parchment paper. And now, of course, it's time to plate up in slow-mo. And Comies, I say it every single week. Once you start understanding these fundamental cooking techniques and putting them into practice, like making a proper caprese salad, knowing how to do it, know how to use the correct ingredients, it will enhance all of your cooking. And it will always be better than any of the restaurants, any of the stores. Because like I always say, homemade food from scratch always tastes better. I'm going to serve this up in a bowl. You can also do a plate or a platter. So add your tomatoes in there. Next, we are going to hit it with those slices of buffalo mozzarella. As a good ratio, I like to use maybe 4-to-1 tomatoes to mozzarella. Next, I'm just going to give this a little mix, sort of incorporate all of those things, because there's a lot of those cherry tomatoes that can get stuck on the bottom, and I want to bring those up to the forefront. You can also do this after we add a lot of the other ingredients. I just like to do it at the beginning. Now I've got some dry oregano. Yes, I've got a fancy set here right on the stems, but of course you can just use dry oregano right out of the bottle. I just think this adds some really great flavors to this. Now we're going to season it very well with some sea salt, fresh cracked black pepper, and once you're done seasoning it, it's time for the olive oil. When it comes to using olive oil as like a sauce or something you want to finish onto certain foods, I always prefer to use extra virgin olive oil. So much more bold, rich flavor. It's cold press. It's that first press of so much deliciousness. And while they do make some great olive oils here in the United States, man, I always try to get something that's imported. I like to get a bottle of something where I can't read anything on it because it's 100% Italian and I don't speak Italian. So now what we need to do is drizzle that delicious olive oil all over the tomatoes. I don't care how much you put on there because it is so dang good. You should definitely try it separate in a little spoon just so you can get an idea. Now I'm going to, of course, add on our fresh basil leaves. And gosh, this just looks so good. Cannot wait to get into this caprese salad. There's a reason this is so simple and has few ingredients. Because when you buy things that are in peak season or the correct version of a specific ingredient, it should taste amazing, just like you see here. Now, check out this beauty. It's easy to make. It's perfect for summer. It's so delicious. You will love it. You have to make this. Be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel. You have to check out this video. I know you'll love it, and I'll see you on there.